the daisies now.
What's happening? What's going on here?
The iron pumps on the blink. The electricity's failed.
What a folly. A ship lying in darkness this way, we might well be rammed at any minute. I'll tend to this myself. Which way is the engine room?
The passengers are not...
I'm sure your chief engineer will welcome the advice of an ex-officer of the Royal Marines.
Look here, you fool. Are we simply abandoned to our fate? I insist on something being done.
For instance?
Well, give out the life belts. Organize the boat drill.
The clientele are requested to remain calm.
To remain calm? Does the captain feel no sense of responsibility for the lives of his passengers?
It's my opinion that the captain doesn't feel much of anything at the moment.
Do you mean to say he's drunk? The fellow ought to be made to walk the plank.
I'm afraid just now he cannot walk at all.
But this is outrageous.
Oh, down, old man. What have you got to worry about? We're only adrift in an open sea with a drunken captain and engine that's liable to explode at any moment.
It's a perfectly ordinary situation. Happens every day. But just in case any of you are still at all anxious, let it be known that Mr. Chelm has taken charge in the engine room.
Who's taken charge?
Harry. And he'll foozle it for sure.
Shall I get out the hymn books?
Your husband claims to have learned all about the engine and such things when he was an officer in the Royal Marines.
If he ever was.
In point of fact, not only was he an officer, but he once won a medal for jumping into a sea of fire to rescue someone. It's only a bit of wreckage, not a man, but that wasn't Harry's fault.
That's a slight error in judgment. Oh, the lights, they come on.
He must have fixed it.
Impossible.
The engines are turning.
We are underway.
I still say it's impossible.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention for a moment? I'm happy to inform you that the oil pump is now in perfect working condition. Putting it right was no great accomplishment for anyone with the slightest mechanical bent. Anyhow, we may now proceed without further delay and in absolute safety.
Oh, Harry, you did. You fooled me.
I think you wrecked my ship. Where is it?
Get out of yourself. Forward, please. Captain wants to see you.
There you are. You David, you wrecked me under the machine!
Nothing of the sort! Some scallywag down there sabotaged my work out of pure malice!
Just blow to my engine!
Now keep your head wide, let's all behave like little gentlemen!
Stay out of this, Dan, Mother! I will handle the brute!
What happens now? Do we get the life belt? Do we abandon the ship?
There's no immediate danger. The passengers were pleased to return to the saloon. We're heading for the nearest port, and there seems to be some chance of our making.
Let's go.